As some of you might already know, the PresMat barometer and the two hot thermometer parts in KSP actually give readouts of their surroundings, and this might help us determine what the atmospheres in KSP are made of. So how might we do this? Well, we are going to use something called the scale height, and this thing is an indicator of how thick an atmosphere is. It is the distance where the density or pressure of an atmosphere decreases by a factor of E. PZ is the pressure at a certain altitude, Z. P0 is the pressure at sea level, and H is the scale height, which depends on the planet that you are on. For example, Earth has a scale height of 8.5 kilometers, meaning that the pressure will have dropped by about 63% at an altitude of 8.5 kilometers. Here are some other scale heights of planets in our solar system for context. Now, before I explain how we can determine the scale height of planets in KSP and how that will help us determine the composition of those planets' atmospheres, I want to show you how this equation came into being. Of course, you can measure this and you can see that it follows this equation along, but you can also prove it mathematically. And don't you dare leave this video now. You people voted that I should delve more into the math, and so that is what I will do, so pay attention. So, imagine you have a cylinder. This cylinder is a tiny piece of atmosphere with a tiny mass dm, a height dz, and a base area of a. And all the forces that are applied to this cylinder are either pushing up or pushing down. The atmosphere is made out of a bunch of these tiny cylinders. What applies to this cylinder must then apply to all. So the total forces applied on the cylinder can be written as follows. Force is the mass times acceleration, and it's equal to the sum of all forces applied to the cylinder. In this case, the mass is dm, and the acceleration is the second derivative over distance z. This might be a bit confusing for those who have not had calculus yet, but moving on. Next, the total forces applied on this cylinder are of course gravity and the atmospheric pressure. Pressure is force divided by area, and so we get this. We also know that a small mass dm is equal to the density of the cylinder times its volume, which is the base area of the shape times the height. Plug this in and we get this. Then divide by surface area A to simplify. Now, we know that an atmosphere is in equilibrium when it comes to these forces that are being applied. They balance each other out. And so the acceleration on the left is zero. Next, the atmosphere conforms to the ideal gas law. N is the number density of particles in the atmosphere, K the Boltzmann constant, and T the temperature. N is the number of particles per volume, which can in turn be expressed like this. Density is the total mass of the particles in the cylinder divided by the volume. If you divide that by the mass of a single particle, then you get the number of particles per volume. This letter mu is the average number of protons and neutrons of an atom or molecule in the atmosphere, and mh is the mass of a hydrogen atom, which is basically the mass of a proton. Plug this into our equation from before and we get this. Now, this whole thing has a unit of meters to the power of minus 1, meaning that this can be written as 1 divided by some distance. We will call that h. Do you see where this is going? Now, the derivative of p over z is apparently minus 1 divided by h times pz. So taking the derivative of p is itself times minus 1 divided by h. This is a property of the number e. And so that means that pz is some constant p0 times e to the power of minus z divided by h. Alright, now we know why the pressure of an atmosphere can be described by this equation. So why do we want to know this scale height? Well, as mentioned before, this mu is the average amount of protons and neutrons in each molecule in the atmosphere. Meaning that if you know this value, we have an idea of what kind of molecules are in the atmosphere. Earth's atmosphere is about 78% nitrogen gas and 21% oxygen. These have molecular weights of about 28 and 32, meaning that our mu for Earth is just below 29. In the case of Venus and Mars, this is around 43, as their atmospheres are mostly made out of CO2. Knowing the equation for the scale height, we can determine this value mu for the planets in KSP. Because we know the masses of these planets, their radii, and their surface temperature, using the two hot thermometer. The last thing we need to determine is the value of the scale height itself, so that we can determine the mean molecular weight. And this we can do using the PresMat barometer. If we measure the pressure at multiple heights in the atmosphere, we can see how fast it drops. which is linked to the scale height. So that is exactly what I did in KSP, and this is what I got for Kerbin. The black points are my measurements, and the red line is the fitted equation with the scale height of about 6 kilometers. You can also see the pressure gradients for different scale heights for comparison. Now, if we plug in everything we know about Kerbin, we get a mean molecular weight of about 40. Now, what molecules could get us to this kind of value? Well, let's get a list of molecular weights of some common gases. Looking at this list, it makes me believe that Kerbin's atmosphere is mostly CO2 with some oxygen and nitrogen. But due to the fact that there is no immense greenhouse effect going on the planet, I believe that there has to be something else at play here. I will leave it to you people to figure it out, and please post your ideas down below, as I'm very curious as to what you can come up with. Measuring the pressures of Eve got me a scale height of 10 kilometers and thus a mean molecular weight of 20.6. A combination of either methane or ammonia with some heavier substance would be possible in this case. I know I mentioned iodine in some previous video as the culprit for its vibrant purple color, and that might still be possible with small amounts dispersed in its atmosphere, but iodine is apparently the 64th most abundant element out of 118, so that is not very likely, but you never know, because there are real life planets out there that seem to have rain of molten iron. If that is not extreme, then I don't know what is. Next, Lathe has a mean molecular weight of 34.4. It being so similar to Kerbin, I would expect an atmosphere of mostly nitrogen, maybe some oxygen, and a sizable amount of CO2. Which is not that strange, knowing that the surface temperature of this moon is quite high, knowing its distance from Kerbal. But it is not the only explanation for its temperature. Finally, Deuna has a mean molecular weight of about 82.6, which is incredibly high, and there are only a few options, and they are quite strange. Honestly, I have no clue what's going on here. Please tell me your ideas down below. So, we found the equation for the pressure depending on altitude, we learned what the scale height is, and calculated this for some plants in KSP, and used it to calculate the mean molecular weights of those planets' atmospheres, and we speculated on what possible combination of molecules would get us to those values. I will post some links down below where I got some of my information used in this video, and feel free to look around. If anyone has some ideas as to what my calculations could mean, or if I made any mistakes, please post them down below, and let's theorize together. Now, due to the fact that this video is quite a bit longer than my usual videos, it also took quite a bit more time to make, and thus I would like to ask everyone who enjoyed this video to subscribe a like. Apparently, 80% of you watching are not subscribed, so please do. Anyways, I hope you all enjoyed it, and until next time.